It's so nice to see you. You look fantastic.
Thank you.
You look great. Well, what do we owe this honor?
I have something really important to ask you because I've really thought about this.
Right.
And I've decided that I am going to resign as Lieutenant Commissioner. I want to do what I do best, and that's manage. If that's okay with you.
You know, you're married to Stone Cold Steve Austin, and you see, Deborah, that changes things. So I would have to have you go talk to Steve and make sure everything's cool with him.
Getting ready for your match?
I'm trying to.
Thought you might need to know this, that I just talked to Mr. McMahon.
You talked to who? What are you talking to Mr. McMahon about? You can't trust him.
In the interest of fairness, officially as of now, you are managing The Rock.
Austin's wife managing The Rock, and by God, what does this mean at WrestleMania in the Reliant Astrodome? Oh my God! And here comes the light from behind! Austin was right in Mr. McMahon's face! It's The Rock and Austin against Triple H and Kurt Angle! I cannot believe what Mr. McMahon has done here!
This is what you call a mind game!
The Rock toys! He's set! He's cocked! He's ready! Rock bottom! This mess continues!
He's going for it!
Angle going for the ankle lock! He'll break The Rock's ankle! And Austin just saved The Rock from getting his ankle broken! The referee just grabbed it! There's a Stone Cold Stunner! Austin going for the cover!
But his wife is distracting the referee!
The Rock now going for the cover! And The Rock gets the pin! Stone Cold and The Rock meet at WrestleMania! But thanks to Mr. McMahon, Stone Cold's wife, Deborah, who's tearing on The Rock, is The Rock's new manager. What does this mean for SmackDown?
I know. It was great Monday night. Listen, Trish was humiliated beyond belief. It was one of the proud... Listen, tonight you're not going to believe the surprise I have for you. No, this is a really, really good surprise. Because it's better than Monday night. This is going to be humiliation like you wouldn't believe. All right, come in. Because this humiliation is more personal even than Trish's. And it's... Let me call you with a
while. You've got just a minute?
Yeah, you seem upset.
Yeah, I'm a little upset right now. Can I talk to you about a couple
absolutely
of things?
Absolutely, please sit down.
Yeah. Well, Mr. McMahon, first of all, I am so shocked about this. It's number one, how you treated Trish Stratus. You totally degraded her. You insulted her in front of all those people. And I don't believe that's how you treat a woman. I don't agree with that.
Well, let me just say this. I know you're upset.
Yeah.
And a lot of other women are upset, and I understand that, because that's no way to treat a lady. I agree with you. I want you to understand that I have the utmost respect for women. Respect. But let me just say this, too, about Trish. Trish, Deborah, Trish is trash. No, I mean, she's not like you, all right? She's not like any other woman that's here. She's trash. And I admit I went too far. I did. I got carried away. And she could have said no at any time, all right? But I got carried away, and I apologize, and you'll never see anything like that again. I humbly apologize. And
okay.
We're okay then, well, you and me? And
yeah,
is that why you wanted to see me?
Well, no. The second thing that's really upsetting me, too, is I cannot believe that you tricked me into managing The Rock. And you know good and well he's going against my husband, Stone Cold Steve Austin, at WrestleMania.
Listen, you know, I'm accused so many times of like, being this Machiavellian character that thinks that in a devious way. And, look, I want to let you understand that, you know, as much as my reputation is that way, from a realistic standpoint, I'm not that kind of man. Let me just say what happened, all right? And hopefully you believe me. If you don't, I understand, and we can talk about that too. But from my standpoint, you came to me, and Deborah, you shocked me Monday night. You resigned. You walked out on me. You resigned as Lieutenant Commissioner. Well, you know, how did I feel about that? You know, and then you say, well, you want to go back to managing. And I'm saying, well, you know, here's a lady who's given everything to the WWF. Here's a lady who's been loyal, a lady who's been a consummate professional, and a lady that I want to reward. So how can I best reward Deborah? Because she deserves it. And the only thing that popped in my mind was you managing the WWF champion. I said to myself, that's going to be fantastic. And granted, you know, as I even said the words and I thought I was rewarding you, it's like, I could understand now the conflicts of Stone Cold and The Rock and where that puts you. And I see that too. But, and if this is that much of a conflict for you, then let me just say that, Deborah, I've always thought of you as a career woman. I've always thought of you as someone who's goal-oriented. But if you want to go back to Texas and be a housewife, I can understand your point of view, but it would be awfully disappointing, because if there's one thing that I think I know about you, is you don't turn your back on a challenge. And this, Deborah, unquestionably, I see it now clearly.
No, I'm willing to do this, most definitely. But I just didn't agree with the way you went about it.
Well, again, I didn't see it for what it was. I thought I was rewarding you. You deserved to be...
It just made me feel very uncomfortable.
I get it. So you're still in, and you still want to accept this challenge.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
All right, then. A deal is a deal.
Yeah.
And just one other thing?
Because it's my job. Right.
And you're a professional.
That's correct.
And just one other thing before you go, I can't help but admire it. That's a very beautiful necklace you're wearing.
Just kind of a habit, I guess. It's like one of the long boys in that 100 years. So you had the conversation, right?
Yeah. Well, I went and talked to Mr. McMahon, and I told him, yes, I want my career back, my job. And then I also told him that I didn't agree with him. He's got me managing. You know that.
Yeah, well, first of all, I'm for your career 100%. I think you're a great manager, and I want you to be as happy as you can be. But Vince McMahon tricked you. That's the bottom line. Nobody knows that man like Stone Cold Steve Austin, because I've been through it all with him. And you got to appreciate the situation you put me in, Deborah. I mean, here it is. You're managing The Rock, the same man that I'm going to WrestleMania with for the WWF title, and you're going to manage him. You understand the kind of position this puts me in?
I know.
Well, I just hope it all works out for the best.
Now, Stone Cold's not happy, and there's his WrestleMania opponent, the champion, The Rock.
You think he knows he's in the handicap match?
With Rikishi and Haku? Soon. Well, Kevin Kelly standing by. And, folks, coming up next, I can't wait to hear what The Rock has to say about his handicap match with Rikishi and Haku tonight.
Haku.
Well,
so you know what our orders are for tonight, right?
Thank you, Fair Fate. The tall biggie Mike, you're tired of getting a rug with lucky door. How the hell you?
Exactly. You're exactly right. That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to take The Rock out. And you know, I ran down Stone Cold Steve Austin with a car. But tonight, I'm going to run my ass right into his wife's face. And then, she's going to smell what I'm cooking.
Say, babe. How you doing,